Because God did all the work. He knows exactly each angel that has fallen. No angels can deceive God. He knows them with great, great intimacy. And he is saying here that these angels from long ago already were prepared for hell. That is, notice he said, to be reserved unto judgment. He talks about them being in hell, being in the grave, having been buried, because it is absolutely guaranteed that that is going to be their end. But it doesn't mean that it's just because he's saying you are in hell, you are under the wrath of God, you are subject to being buried, in a certain sense you're already buried, you're already there, because it's absolutely going to happen. It's absolutely going to happen. But there is a time that still has to be factored in. That time is going to come. That'll be the end of the world. But you are reserved for that. That is all set up. There's no change, no possibility that you're going to avoid that. It's like you've already been buried and you're gone forevermore, even though it's going to finally take place in actuality at the end of the world, in the day of judgment. Now, this is the same language that we're learning, only not in a sentence like this, but as we learn about Ezekiel 39 and other things that we're reading, we are learning that God has done the same with mankind. You see, God went along for 13,000 years. Exactly 13,000 years. Have you ever thought about that? 1988 is the 13,000th anniversary of the history of the world. God went along, and that's the way God's numbers pour out all the time. Exactly 13,000 years, right to the very year, God went along. Mankind are occupying the churches, those who are tares, those who are not elected to become saved, and will never become saved, even though they're convinced they are saved. And finally, God comes to a time where, remember when he said in Revelation, in Matthew 13, let both grow until the harvest, and then will be the separation. And that is what this 23-year Great Tribulation is. It's the period of separation. And the separation is done by testing. Remember again, we've looked at this several times, and we're going to look at it again. Revelation 3, verse 3. We read there, if in the last half of the verse, if therefore thou shalt not come, what am I looking? Verse 10, Revelation 3, verse 10. I couldn't make that work. verse 10, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, that are the true believers, I also will keep thee from the hour of testing. We've talked about this many times, but I want these verses to really lock into our minds. I also want to keep thee from the hour of testing, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. And that hour of testing is the great tribulation period when God, and remember we've talked about this several times, that he's bringing test after test after test to see, are we going to listen to the Bible Or are we going to listen to our own minds or our theologians or our church or whatever? And remember, tests like the Word of God, every word came from the mouth of God. Tests like Christ, we can know the day and the hour, the day and the year when Christ is coming. Our tests like we can know that there's nothing that we can do to assist with our salvation, and that if we are trusting in our water baptism, or trusting in I accepted Christ, that we're still under the wrath of God. These kind of tests, and the very test of the nature of judgment, that we understand what the Bible is saying. And that is happening during this time of great tribulation. And this is the time that God is binding the tares together to prepare for judgment. That is, this God knows, of course, we don't know, but God knows every human being that will fail the test, because anyone who's not saved is in the churches, and they're the ones that are particularly in view, because they have the Bible. If they continue all the way to the end believing that Christ is coming as a thief in the night, or that Christ has not seated Satan in the churches or whatever, it means they failed the test. Now, God doesn't have to wait till the end of that great tribulation period to know who are the ones who are going to fail the test. God knows exactly who is going to fail the test, because if you're not one of the chosen ones, if God has not made payment for your sins long before the foundation of the world, you're going to fail the test. You're not saved. You just aren't saved. And God knows those. And so already in this day, God is binding, and it's so certain, absolutely certain. It's like they are already in hell, even though just like the angels were cast into hell, it's so certain that they are going to be destroyed in the day of judgment, that God speaks of them already in 2 Peter chapter 2 as if they have been cast into hell. And he's saying that they are reserved for judgment. The certainty of this happening is so great, it's so absolute, that God can legitimately say, you've already been cast into hell. And so there are people in the churches today, particularly, and in the world also, who in principle are already in hell. They're already as if they're dead and buried, which is the evidence of hell. It's like they are already there, because God knows they're absolutely not going to become saved. Now, we don't know. We don't know. It's discouraging to us, of course, to look at this, that for years now we have been talking about the end of the church age and about Judgment Day, and how few we have that we know. And most of us have come from the churches, and we have friends in the churches and loved ones and so on. And yet here we're just 17 months away from the end. And the number that are coming out of the churches is so few, so few. If we heard of someone that became a believer, a pastor, and once in a while we do, we rejoice. You see, there is still hope for those in the churches. From our vantage point, there is that hope. And it will be there right till the day of tribulation, to the day of the rapture. But from God's vantage point, it's all cut and dried, absolutely cut and dried, because God knows exactly who is not going to be saved. And so this is a time when He is preparing them, or to reserving them for that final judgment, that as they're preparing them for going into the day of judgment. And this is the language that he's using. But he is giving us evidence, or giving the individuals evidence, so they can make a decision for themselves where they are going. Because remember, the day of the great tribulation is the time of trial. The world, the churches particularly, are being tested. Are you really completely aligned with the Bible, or are you trusting in something other than the Bible, in addition to the Bible? And so he has set up this series of testings, like the time of the end, the character of the judgment day, and all these things that we keep talking about. These are the tests.